What's up, gamers? It's your boy WiiDS-RebeL here with an easy how to do mods video. I started the game about 3 weeks ago and I'm still kind of a noob, but I've gained a little bit of understanding and wisdom into this mod system and I'm here to share it with you. Mods can be extremely confusing and daunting at the start of the game, but they can be the biggest thing to increase your power in a variety of ways. So let's get to it. What do you guys think of the butcher cleavers in my wing and my butt? Right? So you normally think, oh, I'm going to go over to the mods table to work with the mods. No, screw that. The mod table is worthless for anything other than cashing in dupes. Okay? There's nothing else that you can do over here that you can't do at your arsenal. You may not even know this if you're a noob. Check this out. Go to the arsenal. Say you want to work on my Poke Acid Kuva Brock over here. That's actually the name of the enemy I got it from. Poke Acid, I swear to God. And when you're looking at this, your upgrade for your mods. Now, if you want to upgrade Hornet Strike, boom. Press square, baby. It brings you to this window, which is the mods that you have equipped for this weapon, so you don't gotta find them in like the thousand mods that you have. It's only the ones equipped for this weapon. Okay. And you, if you wanted to, just click it and go up to fusion. Boom, boom. You can do it. I'm not gonna do it because it's extremely expensive for this particular upgrade, but that's how you do it. If you wanna go work, you don't have to keep running back and forth and going in and out of these menus. No. You wanna work on the cleavers? I'm thinking, maybe I want to level True Steel up. Okay. Boom. True Steel. Boom, boom. Done. You ain't got to run back and forth. Get in, out of mod. Okay, so the most important thing with mods is like your capacity. And then there's like three mods I'm going to suggest you guys always put on your gun first. Now, it's named different things for different weapon types, but for like the pistol, the damage is called Hornet Strike. The critical damage is called Target Cracker. And the critical chance is called Pistol Gambit. That's the three mods you need, is your damage, crit damage, critical chance. Everything else is secondary. Now, if we go over to like the cleavers, we got a different kind of name for it. That damage over here is called Pressure Point. Organ Shatter is the crit damage. And True Steel is the crit chance. And then you can go ahead and add something like Rending Strike, which is Slash and Puncture. Or something like Scourge, which is Toxin and Status Chance. You normally want to do a like Element and a Status Chance. Or a Slash and Puncture if you have it. Like I call them and mods because it gives you something and something else. Double dipping, baby. Also, something you may not know, look at this right here. I got Crossing Snakes. It's not even leveled up. Now you think, oh, I got 0 at 34 capacity. I can't level it up because I got no room. You're wrong. Look, square to go to mods. Come up with right here. Since it's a stance mod, they work a little different. They don't tell you this shit, okay? Boom, boom, boom. Look it. That would add 3 capacity. And it would say, oh, drain is going from 2 to 5, but it's kind of working differently. It's actually adding capacity to this weapon, bro. Are you ready? It didn't say unequip it because it's going to run out of room. No. It's all good. It gave me room, baby. It gave me 6 room because it's polarized properly. And since it's a stance, it gives you extra room. So how about that? Okay, so now I could put a whole other mod on there. Now let me see. I got pressure point, critical damage, and crit chance and damage. So we're gonna and we got slash and puncture and toxin and stat. We're looking good over here. But I'm thinking I'm gonna add something like fire, maybe turn it into gas. You know what I'm saying? Get the gas cleaver. Yeah, wouldn't that be dope? Yeah, y'all know what I'm talking about. You can have a lot of fun putting other mods on there, but you gotta get your first three. Your damage, your crit chance mods. That's going to increase your DPS insane numbers. You're going to feel the difference when you put it on next. Now, another thing we're going to talk about is polarities. You see, this guy's green compared to like this one. It's got this gray or white kind of color for the polarity. Now, see, if I were to take this off, right, pressure point. Now, it says I only got 5 capacity for mods, right? And the pressure point I had was 9. How did that work? Well, it's because the polarity matches that spot up there. So even though I only have 5 capacity for my mods right now, I throw a 9 in this spot, boom, it goes down to 5. I think it's half rounded up. And so this only takes 5. Boom, I can fit a lot more on there now. Alright. Again, with like this one, like the crossing snakes, this polarity is matched. While I have another one here. Swirling tiger is not matched. This is the double negative kind of polarity. Oh, this is just the dash or the negative polarity. Okay, so that's pretty much it. One more thing, you see the dots down here. That's the other thing of importance. That's how much the mod's been leveled up. You see organ shatter's maxed out. It's got all blue dots. True steel's 2 out of 5. That's how many dots it can level up. Some of them can go more, like, what is it? One of them down here, last thing sting, can go 10 dots. It gets pretty expensive. So, while, you know, pressure point can only go 5. But anyways, y'all, that's pretty much it. You know, just remember some of these basics. You don't have to go to your mod table to work with your mods. You can do it straight from the arsenal. You know, put your damage, your crit damage, and your crit chance mods on first. That's super important. Super important. And try and work with your polarities and your capacities. You guys got it. You're going to be so much stronger. You're going to feel the difference next time you play. Alright, y'all. That's pretty much it. Thank you so much for watching. Consider checking out my other Warframe video I just put up. It's a parody song called We Don't Understand Warframe. A parody of Billy Joel's We Didn't Start the Fire. And it's kind of a noob's experience. What it's like to be a noob in Warframe. But in a funny manner. Thanks, guys. See you next time.